Good afternoon. How are you, my dear students? How have you been? Today we have grammar. Our grammar lesson is about sentences. What's the meaning of sentence? What are the kinds of sentences? So the sentence is a group of words that tell us or show us a complete thought or idea. All the sentences should start with capital letter and they end with punctuation mark. So let's see. Sentences. The sentence is a group of words that tells a complete thought or a complete idea. Every sentence begins with a capital letter. Here we have the first kind of sentences, it's statement. What's the meaning of statement? The statement is a telling sentence. It tells us something. Like when we say, for example, the bear likes to eat honey. The horse is brown. So when the sentence tells something or gives information, so it's a statement. Like the girl has a long hair, the boy is smart, or the boy has a big house, or whatever. Okay, so when the sentence tells us something, it is a statement. The statement begins with a capital letter and ends with a period or full stop. Like the ship sailed across the ocean. The second type of sentences, it has another name. The statement has another name. It's declarative. Declarative. Okay. Statement or declarative sentence. Here we have question or interrogative sentence. It has two names. The interrogative sentence is a question. The declarative sentence is a statement. So the question asks something and it begins with a question word like what, do, when, where, who. So like, what color is the dog? How old are you? How are you? Do you like pizza? Do you like ice cream? Where were you? So the question starts with a capital letter and ends with a question mark. And it can be answered like, what color is the dog? Its color is brown. How are you? I'm good, for example. How old are you? I'm 8 years old. What's your favorite color? What do you like to do? What do you want to eat? Whatever. So the question can be answered like, what color is the dog? The dog is brown. The question starts or begins with a question word. What are the question words? The question words like, here's a few of them. Who, may, why, would, was, how, did, does, which, is, like, is it your bag, are, for example, are you coming, can you write a story, or can you write a poem, or can you build a house, for example, could, when. We use one to ask the time or to ask about the place, what to ask about something. We will use do with plural nouns, does with singular nouns or with third persons like he, she, it. It is the past of do and does. Okay, so let's practice now. We're going to tell if this is a question or a statement, and we're going to tell why did we choose question or statement, or how do we know that? Question or statement. The children are playing. So this sentence tells us something, that children are playing. So this is statement. How did we know? Because it tells us something. Statement or declarative sentence. The bluebird sings loudly. It tells us something about the bird. He sings loudly. So it's statement or declarative sentence. Where is the kitten? Where is the kitten? Can you answer this question? How did we know it's a question? Because it ends with a question mark and it begins with a question word, and we can answer it. Where is the kitten? The kitten is in the box. So this is a question or interrogative sentence. So let's write question. When will the football game start? When? It is a question word. It asks about the time. When will the football game start? And here we have a question mark. So this is a question and we can answer it. We can say it will start, for example, 5 p.m. So this is question or interrogative sentence. What color is the bus? This sentence begins with a question word. What? What color is the bus? And we can answer it. It's pink. So this is a question or interrogative sentence. The boy is mad. It tells us something. The boy is mad. Look at him. He's really mad. So this is, and we can't answer it. We can listen to it and get information. So the boy is mad. This is statement or declarative sentence. The duck quacks a lot. This sentence tells us something. It tells that the duck quacks a lot. So this is a statement. Okay, so we finished. Don't forget the statements the statements are telling sentences. They tell us things and they end with a period. The questions are ask us, or they are asking sentences, or they ask us something and we can answer them, and they end with a question mark and they begin with question words. So again, what's the meaning of questions? The question asks you something, it ends with a question mark and it begins with a question word, like what are you doing? The statement tells you about something. It ends with a period, like we are drawing a sun. So now get your grammar book. Here we have a sentence. What's the meaning of sentence? The sentence is a group of words that tells a complete thought or a complete idea. Every sentence begins with a capital letter. It begins with a capital letter. The statement is a sentence that tells something. The statement is a sentence that tells something. The statement ends with a period. So like, Max is my friend, he plays with me. Circle the sentence in each row. My friend helps me, the same sentence. But here the sentence begins with capital letter and ends with period. So this one is the sentence. The other one, it's not a sentence because it didn't start with capital letter and it doesn't have a period at the end. Jake goes with me to the park. Here we can't see the period at the end, but you can see the capital letter and the period at the end. So this one is the sentence. But let's look at these sentences. My friend helps me. It's a statement because it tells us something. Jake goes with me to the park. It's a statement too because it tells us something. We walk to school together. It's a statement because it tells us something. So which one is the correct sentence, or which one is a sentence? The second one, because it begins with capital letter and ends with a period. Kara likes to dance. Both of them have a capital letter in the beginning, but this one doesn't have a period at the end. So this one is the sentence, the first one. I showed Kara how to sing. the same words, but here we have a capital letter. Both of them have capital letter in the beginning, but the first one doesn't have a period. The second has a period. So this one is the sentence. I sing with my friend. I sing with my friend. Here we have capital I and period. Here we have small I. So this one is the sentence. Don't forget to write the day and date. Now let's see. Here we have question. The question, let's underline it. Let me change the color. Here, the question is a sentence that asks something. It ends with a question mark. The statement is a sentence that tells something. It ends with a period. I play tag. Statement, will you play tag here? It starts or begins with question word and ends with a question mark, and it can be answered. Will you play tag? Yes, I will, or no, I won't, or I will not. So read the sentence, circle each question. So we're going to circle the question and underline the statement. Will that help you read the book? Here we have a question word and question mark. So this is a question. Will that help you read the book? Yes, he will, or no, he won't. So it can be answered. Who are your friends? We can tell their names. And it begins with question word. Who are your friends? I ate dinner at Lisa's house. I ate dinner at Lisa's house. They tell us something, so, or he tells us something. So this is a statement, underline. Sam helped me rake the leaves. It tells us something. So this is a statement. I watched this game. This is a statement because it tells something. Will you go to the movies with me? He's asking, will you come with me? So this is a question, and we have a question mark at the end. So we're going to circle it. My friend takes care of me. My friend takes care of me. Here he tells us something. So this is a statement, and we have a period at the end. Sarah shows Ted the new game. They tell us something. She shows him the new game. So this is a statement. Do you have homework tonight? Do you have? Yes, I have, or no, I don't have. It starts or begins with question word and ends with question mark. So it is a question and we can answer. Do you have homework tonight? Yes, I have, or no, I haven't. Friends help each other. It is a telling sentence because it tells us something. So it is a statement. What's the meaning of statement? Declarative. Question, interrogative. Now, capitalization and punctuation, the telling sentence or the statement end with a period. The asking sentence or question ends with a question mark. Beth likes to laugh. It's a statement. It ends with a period. Do you like to laugh? Here it is a question. We have a question mark and a question word. Do you like to laugh? Yes, I like. Yes, I like to laugh. Or we should say, yes, I like, or no, I don't like. But I think all of you like to laugh, right? So read the sentences, write the sentences correctly on the line. Dunny sits next to me. He sits next to me. Here, he tells us something. So we should put period at the end because it's a telling sentence. We should start with capital letter and put a period at the end. Will we have the same teacher? Will we have, it's a question because it starts or begins with a question word. It's will here. Will we have the same teacher? So we should put a question mark at the end. And we can answer it, yes, we will, or no, we will not. We will have, will we have the same feature? Okay. The boys helped rake the leaves. It's a telling sentence because it tells us something. The boys helped rake the leaves. Period. The friends walked to school. It's a telling sentence or statement, so we should put period at the end. Here, will you help me? It's a question because it begins with a question word and we should put, will you help me? Yes, I will, or no, I won't. So let's put a question mark at the end. Okay. So page number 4 and 5 are homework. I think I have a problem. Okay, here we love to do your homework. You love to do your homework and I like to check them or correct them. But I think you won't have any mistake. So page number 4 is a homework and page number 5 is a homework. Good luck, see you later. Bye.